The battle between BYD and Tesla has truly just started to reach historic levels. I mean, this is crazy. What is going on right now? It's amazing. It's driving insane growth in the electric vehicle industry. I mean, who would have thought 2 years ago? Look back 2 years ago, right? Look at the vehicle deliveries of Tesla. Look at the vehicle deliveries of BYD. Who on earth would have thought we would be here today? Well, not many people, that's for sure. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel on the Electric Viking. Great to see you. Welcome to all the new subscribers. Great to have you here. Welcome back, everyone else. Great to have you too. Thank you for subscribing and for supporting the channel. Now, when I started the channel about 18 months ago, I made a lot of videos about BYD showing their spectacular rise in vehicle delivery sales. But not only their spectacular increase in sales, but their spectacular transformation of their company from basically a predominantly gasoline-powered vehicle selling company into one of the world's largest selling EV manufacturers, and it happened very quickly. Who would have thought that within such a short space of time, BYD would stop selling gasoline-powered vehicles and ramp up its own vehicle sales to historic proportions? I mean, the vehicle run rate BYD are at right now is equivalent in 2 months to an entire year of sales just 3 years ago. In 2 months. Now, the thing is, right? BYD just hit over 200,000 new energy vehicle sales in September. What's a new energy vehicle? What's electric vehicles, plug-in hybrids, combination of the two? They sold 105,000 plug-in hybrids and 100,000 electric vehicles, just over 200,000. Crazy. The thing is, this is just the start. It sounds crazy. It sounds mental. When you look at this chart, right, it's going up every single month, increase in production every single month. Who would have thought this would happen? This would be sustainable, that this would keep on going month after month after month. Well, those of you following the channel, a lot of you knew this would happen because you've been seeing and hearing about what the company's been doing, their plants, their battery gigafactories, their car gigafactories, the fact they're just buying up anyone's factory, any car factories, the car companies that are going bankrupt, they're buying their factories and just turning them into electric vehicle factories within a very short space of time. Now, BYD are saying, right, you would have thought they'd be happy with this. This is a run rate right now of 2.4 million cars per year. 2.4 million cars per year. That's their current run rate. That basically means they've quadrupled the size of their business in 1 year. That is insane. Who would have thought that would happen? But the thing is, they're not happy with that. BYD CEO Wang Shanfu, by the way, if you don't know who the guy is, you need to know he's very similar to Elon Musk in a lot of ways. I'll put a link in the description below. Fascinating story. He was an orphan. Read about it. Check it out. That's one of my most, probably my most interesting videos that I think I've done. It was actually a really fascinating journey to learn about him, to see what makes him tick. So I'll put a link in the description below to that video. Check out his background. Now he's saying BYD will deliver 280,000 vehicles per month by the end of the year. That is mental, because that would put the company at a run rate of 3.4 million plug-in hybrid and electric vehicles per year. But, I mean, BYD is saying that that's not enough. That's not good enough. They want to hit 4 million deliveries next year. Can you imagine how many vehicles these guys want to actually manufacture and sell in 2025? Can you imagine how many they want to sell in 2030? I'm sure many of you have seen my video talking about my sales projections. Well, yeah, those are different now. They've changed, obviously. Clearly, this race now, Legacy Auto, they're finished, they're done. When I say finished and done, they're not all going to go bankrupt. Of course, some of them will still exist. When I mean Legacy Auto are finished and done, I mean they are not going to win this race. There is no question this race is between only two horses, and those two horses are clearly Tesla and BYD. Who will win? At this point, you've got to say it's looking like BYD have a better chance of delivering more vehicles in 2030 than Tesla. Why? Because they're covering every segment. But there is one big fly in the ointment. BYD, yes, they do make a profit, but a very small profit per car. They only make about $1,000 per car, which is really good when you consider the fact that all of the competition make nothing and they make a loss, except for Tesla, of course, who make a lot more than $1,000 per car. In fact, Tesla on average are making around about $15,000 per car in China. Now, that's obviously going to change. Tesla's price is going to come down. However, Tesla, you know what they do? They always seem to pull something out of the bag. They always seem to find a way to make their cars cheaper. Structural battery packs, you know, using lithium iron phosphate batteries. Of course, BYD does the same thing as well. But they seem to be able to sell at a higher price than BYD cars. So obviously, Tesla has the advantage. It has more cash, has more cash flow, and it has higher margins. BYD, on the other hand, well, they have an advantage in terms of look how many models they've got. I mean, they've got 20 plus models covering off every segment. They've got affordable cars. They've got luxury cars. They're bringing out more higher end cars soon as well. That's going to be interesting to see. Now, let's have a look at BYD's sales numbers this year and see if we can work out where they're going to be by the end of this year. In January, BYD delivered 93,000 electric vehicles and plug-in hybrids. Almost none of those were gasoline-powered cars. Of course, plug-in hybrids do have a motor in them still. But the thing is about BYD's plug-in hybrids is that many of them have a range of about 200 kilometers. So they're not these ridiculous plug-ins that you see in a lot of European cars where they've got a range of, you know, look at the latest Mercedes, right? The latest Mercedes C63 AMG, $200,000 for that car, Australian dollars anyway, probably about $130,000. It's got a range, no joke, 12 kilometers. 12 kilometers. It's a plug-in hybrid. It's got a range of 12 kilometers. I mean, that's ridiculous. You can get a BYD vehicle with 200 kilometers of real-world range, or at least 150 kilometers minimum of real-world range. So BYD's plug-in hybrids, they are actually worth buying. I don't think it's worth buying a plug-in hybrid with a 12-kilometer range. To me, that's just ridiculous, especially for the price they're selling Mercedes. I don't know why they made that car. It's a joke. That's my opinion. If you haven't seen that car, I'll put a link in the description below. Two transmissions, three battery packs. It's the most complicated vehicle made in the history of mankind. If you buy that thing, you deserve some pain. You deserve some warranty pain because honestly, I warned you, it's, and you should have warned yourself. Look at the complexity of that thing. It's ridiculous. Anyway, BYD's cars, plug-in hybrids. Do I recommend getting one? No, I don't. Absolutely not. I recommend getting an EV because EVs will have by far the best resale value, by far. Eventually, plug-in hybrids will be old and no one will want them. And there is a big challenge for BYD. But the challenge they have is they're going to have to start moving away eventually from plug-in hybrids. Demand for those will go down. It's sure, it's pretty good in China. Well, actually not that good. If you think about it, Chinese vehicle sales, electric cars are about 26% of the market. Plug-in hybrids, only about 5%. That's a pretty small percentage. BYD has the majority of that market right now. But in most of the world, plug-ins, their vehicle deliveries as a percentage are actually going down, whereas EVs are going up. Clearly, people see EVs as the future. January, BYD, 93,000, right? Then they've gone from 93,000 to March, 104,000, well, 105,000. Then let's fast forward to July, 162,000, then 175,000. And then, of course, 200,260 deliveries in September. Let's compare that to last year, though. That's an increase of 183% from 71,100 units in the same month last year and 15% from 175,000 in August. Now, if you're new to the channel, BYD are on the precipice of becoming a global brand. You're probably thinking, oh, it's just a Chinese car brand. Pretty much that's correct right now. Yeah, they do sell EVs. And other vehicles, of course, buses, electric buses, commercial buses, electric trucks as well. They do sell them in other countries, but the truth is the numbers are very, very small. I mean, here's the numbers. Overseas passenger electric vehicle sales, 7,700 in September. But there's a lot of BYD vehicles being shipped right now all around the world. For example, BYD just listed the prices, and I made a video about it, of three different electric cars that will be on sale in numerous European countries within the next few months. Already now, the Atto 3 is on sale here in Australia. It's on sale in New Zealand. They're going to the UK. Many, many other countries around the world, including South America, including countries in Asia, numerous countries in Asia, of course, Thailand, Singapore. The list goes on. BYD have huge plans for everywhere except for the United States. Why? Well, BYD do want to become a US electric car brand. They do want to get a part of the US market. Why wouldn't you? I mean, it's a massive car market. It's what, a quarter of global car sales. It's extremely important for BYD's future, but they need to work out a way to make that work. But they're going to go for the low hanging fruit first. Much easier to sell EVs in Europe right now without big taxes, right? Yeah, there's big taxes on electric vehicles from China in the US, which is totally fair enough because China does the same thing to the US. Basically, the US turned around and said, yeah, we're going to do the same thing as you. Totally get that. But there is a way to get around this. I believe BYD will plan on actually sending the parts, the chassis, the battery pack, the skateboard to the US, then having a factory. They already have a factory in California. They already have a couple of factories in the US, in fact. Then sending them there to their factories in the US and assembling them in the United States. But several politicians in the US have gone after BYD in the past. They've been discussed publicly. People don't mention this, but it's actually been discussed publicly by politicians that they should try to limit BYD's potential in the US. They should try to suppress the company a little bit. I made a video about those politicians, about what they said, about how they'd kind of gone after BYD a little bit. I'll put a link in the description below to that video. That was about 18 months ago. But of course, the same political climate still exists in terms of the anti-China sentiment in the US. And I understand where people are coming from. Totally fair enough. Let's get back to BYD sales. From January to September, BYD's cumulative sales of electric vehicles and plug-in hybrids is now 1.2 million, or 1,180,000. That's an increase of 250% from only 337,000 in the same period last year. So BYD has grown in size by 250%. That is crazy. And the thing is, I mean, they're saying these numbers are going to go up to 280,000 by the end of the year. And I mean, you'd be a fool not to believe them considering their track record over the past 18 months, which is just truly spectacular. For example, when I talk about track record, BYD has said very little. Like, they've said very little. They've made very few promises. They've said things like, we have a backlog of 500,000 vehicles, and that's a problem. We need to get on top of that. But they haven't said, oh, we're going to go and deliver, you know, a million EVs, rah, 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 like other companies have. XPeng, for example, said they delivered 300,000 EVs this year. They came nowhere near close to it. BYD, though, they've been very subtle about their promises. If they say, though, they're going to deliver 280,000 EVs by the end of the year, so meaning in December, that will be their delivery goal, very good chance they're going to hit those numbers. So far this year, BYD's year-to-date sales of pure electric cars was 582,000. An increase of 214% from 185,000 in the same period last year. Plug-in hybrids, 593,000. So very close, 582 versus 593, up 307% from 145,000 last year. Let's have a look at comparing them to Tesla. So far this year, the first three quarters of the year, Tesla have delivered 909,000 electric cars. So if you're comparing apples with apples, that means Tesla are ahead of BYD by about 320,000 EVs, purely electric cars. BYD, 582,000 versus Tesla's 909,000. But if you're comparing new energy vehicles, meaning we put electric cars together with plug-in hybrids, of course, BYD are at quite a bit more than Tesla, nearly 1.2 million versus Tesla's 910,000, meaning BYD have a pretty significant lead now on total vehicle deliveries this year. Personally, though, I think the more fair comparison is fully electric cars. But hey, a lot of people disagree with me on that. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Who is winning this year in your opinion, Tesla or BYD? Let me know what you think. Now, of course, doesn't matter who's winning. The ultimate point here in this video is to say both these companies are absolutely killing it this year. Both of them are succeeding in a massive way. Personally, I'm invested in both of these companies, and it's been an incredible journey to follow them this year. I'm going to have a lot of fun over the next decade sharing with you guys what's going on with these two companies and watching them start taking massive market share from these legacy auto companies who are still really not taking electric cars seriously. They say they are, but are they really? I don't think so.